My name is Dr. Murali Krishna. I'm a practicing veterinarian. I'm in the field of past 23 years. I'm working for the Department of Animal Husbandry. And I promote ethno-veterinary practice in my state of Karnataka. Here I'll be telling about the treatment for mastitis in ethno-practice, where we use aloe vera. Aloe vera is also known in Kannada as Lole Sara. Today, I'm going to explain you about mastitis. The case which is being referred here, it's a typical case of mastitis where there will be inflammation of the udder. So it causes because of infection in the udder, due to non-milking of the cow 100% fully in the morning. And usually the mastitis cow will have a pyrexia, that is increase in temperature. As you could see in this cow, the cow is panting with a little more of temperature, more than 104 degree Fahrenheit, and even the nasal discharge is there, and there is a swelling in the udder. So this is the 100% case of mastitis. In mastitis, there will be inflammation of the udder, especially the affected quarter will show signs of inflammation. And you can see the udder now, there is a swelling in that part of the udder where the udder has been affected. It is the fore quarter and the hind quarter, both of them have been affected. So there will be inflammation, and touching the animal evinces pain, and even sometimes it kicks. There is a problem of infection because it may be of any bacterial or viral or fungal infection, and this is a case of bacterial infection only. Wherein mastitis, there will be a rise in temperature and animal is showing the evidence of panting here, and the hurried respiration is also been seen here. Here the main changes that which you are observing is there will be curdling of milk, as you see now in this plate, and also there will be coloration of the milk. Usually the milk will be white in color, but here the milk has turned into yellow in color. So that's the main symptoms of mastitis. Whenever the farmers observe the change in coloration of milk and the curdling of milk and even the plaques, as you see now, the farmer should start first aid using the ethno-veterinary practice, which I will be telling it now, and I will be demonstrating how we should do it also. This plant is called aloe vera. In Kannada it is called Lole Sara. And even in Kannada, sometimes in some of the parts of Karnataka, they also called Olle Kathale in Kannada. So it's a plant where there is a gel inside. I'll show you the gel afterwards. The materials what we require is the main is the aloe vera, which is a plant which doesn't need much of water. It can grow anywhere in Karnataka or anywhere in the world. It has got its own property where it doesn't require more of water. That's the main property of it. And then we require 1.5 dressing of lemon. And juice will be taken out from the lemon, and we extract the juice, and also we put the turmeric powder, which is called haldi. So that we have about 2 to 3 spoons of turmeric, and then a castor oil can also be used here. So this castor oil has the function of acting along with the aloe vera onto the udder. It sticks to the udder, and then it acts the anti-inflammatory property and acts the antibiotic property it has got, and it prevents spread of mastitis in the udder. And before the doctor comes, the farmer can take up this first aid. We have to slit the portion of aloe vera leaf, and then we have to take out the green coloration above that leaf, as being shown now. So you could see a jelly inside. So this jelly has the property of antiseptic and antibiotic property, where it prevents the spread of mastitis, and the inflammation can also be subsidized. It's a local ethno-veterinary practice where the farmers in my area practice here. So this is a gel which you are seeing now, which I am taking it out. For each affected udder, we may require around 50 to 100 grams of aloe vera pieces like this. The gel which has been taken out, per time it requires 50 to 100 grams depending on the size of the quarter. But what the farmer should do, you should have about 2 to 3 cuttings for a day, and then you should apply it on the adar. So this is the jelly which we are taking it out, and we will be adding 2 spoonful of turmeric, that is haldi, to this mixture. You should add the lemon juice. You should squeeze the lemon and take out the juice. Now I am adding about 2 spoonful of castor oil. Usually all these ingredients are available with the farmer in his house. So that's a first aid ethno-veterinary practice that we can do in prevention of spread of mastitis before the doctor comes for the treatment. Now you should mix it so that the jelly, the turmeric, the castor oil and the lemon juice, everything will be mixed into the form of a paste. So this paste can be applied over the adar. This paste should be applied on the adar where the animal has got the mastitis. This is the affected adar, the quarter, where I am applying the paste which I have prepared and which I have shown you should be applied over the adar, and light massages to be done. So that prevents the spread of mastitis in the adar and also works as an anti-inflammatory in the adar. So this is the one of the ethno-veterinary practice where all the farmers in a village can practice this. So it should be applied like this, even on the teeth. The full quarter has to be applied. So this has to be continued for 2 to 3 times a day. So that prevents the spread of mastitis in the adar. As I have shown you now, this is the way that you should apply over the adar with the affected quarter. Jelly which we have applied containing aloe vera, the turmeric powder, the castor oil and the lemon juice, that should be applied 2 to 3 times in a day before, and even it works as a first aid treatment of ethno-veterinary practice, what the farmers can do before the doctor comes to his place for the treatment of mastitis. The one thing should the farmer should remember is that the affected quarter milk should not be let down onto the ground, and it should be collected in a bowl of steel bowl or any bowl containing, that should not spill over on the ground. The affected quarter milk should not be placed on the ground so that it may affect the other quarter in the coming days. Thank you very much.